Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video we are going to cover the basics of Roman numerals, how to read and write them. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. Different types of numeral systems exist beside the one we commonly use. Our numeral system is called the Hindu-Arabic numeral system and forms the decimal number system. However, Roman numerals are an ancient system of numbers that was used in the Roman Empire. They are still used today in certain contexts, such as on clock faces and book chapters. Firstly, let's look at the symbols used in Roman numerals. There are seven standard symbols in total. The first Roman numeral is I, which represents the number 1. The next numeral is V, which represents 5. X represents 10. L represents 50. C represents 100. D represents 500. And M represents 1000. There are various ways to help you remember the Roman numeral symbols. It is believed the Romans used hand signals for remembering Roman numerals up to 10. Mnemonics can also help us recall the order of Roman numerals. Here are some examples. See if you can come up with your own mnemonic to help you remember the Roman numerals, and post it in the comments below. You may be wondering about the numbers in between the ones we have covered so far, such as the number 7, or 48 for example. Well, the Roman numerals we have looked at so far can be combined to create the other numbers by adding or subtracting the values of each symbol. Let's look at the number 7. How can we make the number 7 from the Roman numerals we have? We can add a 5 and 2 ones together to make 7. Now let's look at the number 48. As you can see, it is slightly more complicated. This is because there are certain rules we need to follow when working with Roman numerals. We can't just write 4 tens, a 5, and 3 ones. Let's have a look at the rules to find out why. Symbols are always read from left to right, starting with the largest symbol. So when you see a long Roman numeral, look for the largest value first and start from there. If a smaller symbol appears before a larger symbol, you subtract the smaller value from the larger value. For example, IV is 4, not 6, as we start at V because it is the largest, and then subtract anything that comes before. You can only subtract a power of 10, I, X, or C, from the next two higher powers of 10. For example, you can subtract I from V or X, but not from L or M. Usually, the same symbol is not used more than 3 times in a row. Let's look at some examples. I is the number 3, as we have 3 lots of 1s. I, X, is the number 9, as we start with the largest value, X, which represents 10, and we take away any values to the left. For the number 24, we have 2 X's, which are equal to 2 10s. The next largest number is V, with an I before it, which means we take 1 away from 5, giving us 4. So we can then add the 2 10s and the 4, to make 24. Finally, the number 99 is written by starting with the largest value, C, which is equal to 100. There is an X before the C, so we subtract 10 from 100 to get 90. After this, the next highest value is the X at the end, equal to 10. We subtract the I before it, leaving us with 9. So we have 90 plus 9. Now let's see how to convert the number 1967 into Roman numerals. You may want to watch our video about place value, linked above, for a recap. Firstly, we break the number down into its component parts, thousands, hundreds, tens and units. We can then convert each part to the appropriate symbol. Once we have the symbols for each part of the number, we can combine them together to get the equivalent Roman numeral. Have a go at these practice questions. You can use the chart on the right to help you. Pause the video while you work them out. Thanks for watching Minity Maths. Subscribe for more videos.